I know what's going on there. They decided to take hostages because they're desperate. That's their play because they're protecting someone. I'm sure Chaco's in there. My wife's in there too. I'm sure he'll use her as hostage the moment he sees her. It might be better if you work together with Rian. She's the only one who can help you capture Chaco.
Marshal, I'm not gonna team up with your daughter. I'm not your subordinate. You have no right to give me orders, you understand?
Look, I'm not giving you orders. I'm begging you right now. Please save them all.
Sir, you forgot one major factor. What about Bonifacio? Are we certain that we can trust her with this?
I don't think it will hurt if we trust Bonifacio a little bit.
Rian, this is Major Del Fierro. Right now, we need your help to save the hostages and capture Chaco. We have to know the exact location and movement of our target. We're counting on you, Rian.
Ethan, I found Chaco and his men. I'm tailing them now.
We need a way in, Rian. Over.
I'm on it.
Franco, I think it's better if we split up.
General, we're not gonna leave you.
Listen to me carefully, Franco. It's better if we split up. Understood? Go on.
Let's go.
You're free to go. The soldiers are here. Don't worry.
Area clear. All hostages secured.
Remember what I told you. You have nowhere to go now.
You know what? I'm actually glad this happened, Rian. Now I can assess for myself how good you really are. Let's see what you got. Let's end this right here, Rian. Because I promise you this. If you don't kill me right now, I will never leave your family in peace.
Sir, we found Chaco! Show me your hands!
Don't shoot!
Don't move, Chaco! Hands in the air!
Sir, have mercy!
You're under arrest for smuggling of firearms, manufacturing and selling illegal drugs, kidnapping, murder, and rebellion.
Son, tell me what happened.
Marshal, it's Rian. We're at the hospital right now. Our daughter's been shot, Marshal.
I want to know where my husband is. Where is Chaco Guerrero?
Ma'am, just calm down. Calm down.
I won't calm down until I talk to my husband. Where's Chaco? Why did the police take him here?
Ma'am.
Where's my husband? I haven't been able to talk to my husband in ages, and then I find out the authorities had him locked up in here? What's wrong with the authorities of this country? Don't you feel sorry for us, or at least our son?
Just calm down,
Mrs.
please.
Guerrero.
Just calm down.
Mrs. Guerrero, let me handle this. Good afternoon, sir. I'm Mr. Guerrero's lawyer.
All right, sir.
Ma'am, please just stay here while the general's being questioned. I'll come back once we're done.
Yes, attorney. You need to be able to fix this immediately, and Chaco has to be able to leave this place today.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Here is the latest update on the hostage crisis at Gift for a Cause earlier. We received unconfirmed reports that Rian Bonifacio, the alleged primary suspect in the bombing of Capitol Mall, where hundreds of people died, was sighted at the event. And according to one of our trusted sources, Bonifacio was one of the casualties in the said incident.
Ma? Was this because of Rian? Yes, Sandy.
Sir, Chaco is now under police custody. But because of the case we have against him, we were able to talk to Chief into letting our team conduct our own interrogation.
I'll go straight to the point, Mr. Guerrero. What were you doing at the bazaar?
Lieutenant, my client can't
answer.
Attorney.
It's all right. It's all right. Those people took me. They wanted to ask for ransom money from my wife. But one thing I cannot do is to put my family in danger. So I thought the best thing to do at that time is to pretend I wanted to join their group. Too bad for me it didn't work. They weren't convinced I meant it. So they decided they'd test my loyalty by taking me themselves to the bazaar.
Did you know there were drugs in the bazaar?
Yes, ma'am, I did.
Of course he knew about the drugs because you were their leader.
No, Lieutenant, that's not true. I'm not their leader. I already told you I was kidnapped.
So what were you doing at the bazaar?
I already told you why I was there. I was only pretending. I thought it was best to pretend that I decided I wanted to be their ally. Because to be honest, I was really hoping that once again I gained their trust. They'll think it'll be good to bring me to their operations, and then I'll use that opportunity to escape and run away. And my plan worked. They really brought me to the bazaar. Lieutenant, whether you believe it or not, I admit, I am no saint, but I will never allow any plot to destroy innocent lives to succeed. So when Pandemonium erupted, I figured it was my only chance to escape. And I admit, I stole their drugs, but it was only to prevent it from being distributed.
So who had you taken then? Didn't you say you were kidnapped by these people? Why don't you tell me their names?
If I give you all their names, Lieutenant, can you swear you'd be able to protect me? And the lives of my family? We're not talking about a small-time syndicate. They have solid connections, very influential and powerful.
Or maybe you yourself are protecting them.
Lieutenant, I cannot afford to risk everything. Knowing that it's going to cost me the life and safety of my own family.
Don't you think Chago Guerrero's acting strange? Because we all know him, and he's nothing like that. He'll never allow himself to be the victim, especially now that he has his back against the wall.
This is all just a show. I will post bail, attorney, no matter the price. I don't want to be locked up in here.
General, some of your charges are non-bailable. That terrorism charge is impossible to win. And also, I was informed of a military intelligence report on you attesting that there's a strong evidence of guilt. I'm afraid the best move is to wait for the court's decision before we get you out of here.
Attorney, I haven't been sentenced with anything yet. I'm paying you to get me out of here, am I not? Now where's that toughness you bragged you have?
All right, sir. I'll do everything in my power to get you out of this prison. We'll look into all the possible legal loopholes.
Okay.
You can't go beyond this point, sir.
I understand. Sir, I'll go ahead.
All right, attorney. Hey, boss. Aren't there any available cells here? There's no room for me here, see?
General, no one gets special treatment here.
Welcome. You smell good.
What'd he say? Special treatment, huh?
So good.
How about you sleep on the floor?
Looks like he's loaded.
Smells like one, too.
He does.
What are you guys laughing at? You think you can just open your mouth and scare me? You want me to scare you into not waking up the following day? You don't know who you're messing with.
Chago?
What?
Huh?
Amelia.
Chago.
Amelia. You must do everything you can to get me out of here. Look at our condition here. It's so inhumane we're packed like sardines in a can here.
I'll do anything so I can get you out of here.
You better. But listen to me. For now, our only option is to play weak and beat a victim. I need to convince the authorities that I know nothing and I'm innocent. Santi. Be the one to take care of your mom for now, okay? And don't worry, son. Your papa's gonna get out of here in no time.
Rupa, you can count on me. I'll take care of mama.
All right, Amelia. You should go now.
Scalpel.
Hang in there, Rian. We'll be waiting here for you.
I still haven't gotten an update from Corazon.
My child, try to control your nerves. Calm down!
Calm down? My wife was taken hostage earlier, and now my daughter is dying. What do you expect me to do? Just sit here and do nothing?
Michelle, you know you're still under investigation. And you also know they won't allow you to do whatever you please. Besides, she's with good doctors. Those doctors know what they're doing. My hands are tied. I can only keep you company.
Fine. I'll just do it without your help, then.
Listen, you no longer have command. You're all alone. Can't you realize that? And listen to me. Don't you dare do anything. You'll just put yourself in deeper trouble. I know you know that.
What I know is what I must do.
Mayo. Here. The bullet hit an artery in her heart. She's lost a lot of blood. Call the blood bank and ask them to prepare 2 fresh bags of blood. Clamp. Copy.
We were born in this world without knowing who we are. What we are. What we will become. And what kind of future life has in store for us. But we fight on. Even if we don't have the answers.
Nurse, what's her blood pressure?
Her BP is dropping.
She's lost too much blood. Clamp, do we have the blood? Follow it up.
More often than not, we stumble through the dark. We fall down. And we get hurt. We suffer defeat. But how long can we endure our sufferings? How long can we keep on fighting?
Vital dropping, Doctor.
She's going into cardiac arrest. Clear the area. We need a defib. Prepare the defib. Jump. Clear?
Clear!
Defib!
Of life. Are we just going to accept defeat without putting up a fight? There's a reason why we still choose to wake up to a new day. And why we choose to stand up every time we fall. And as long as the people we love are still with us, then we'll keep on fighting. And we do it for them.
Give me the blood.
Heartbeats back to normal.
What's Rian's status?
The doctors aren't done with her yet, and we're still waiting. Hold on, Marsha. Doctor, how's my daughter? How was the surgery?
She survived. She's stable now. We've removed the bullet from her body. But you can't see her yet. We need to move her to the recovery room for post-monitoring. Oh, by the way, ma'am, we took this from the patient before the surgery. We almost lost her, but it seems she was determined not to leave you, ma'am.
Thank you, doctor. Marsha? Marsha, Rian's out of danger now. Wow, that terrified me.
Sorry, it's my fault. I shouldn't have brought you to that place.
It wasn't your fault, Ivan. We both know you didn't know that would happen. It's not as if you're friends with those people for you to know what they were planning. I'll just get you a drink. Here you go.
You don't understand the gravity of it. Those people, they're ruthless. What if you both got hurt back there? What if you got trapped in that place?
You told me that I should trust you, and that's what I'm doing. I'm trusting you with my life, Ivan. And even if I thought it was impossible for us to get out of there, I still trusted you. I'm really grateful to you, Ivan. I can't remember how many times you've saved my life, but I know that no matter how many times I tell you how grateful I am to you, it will never be enough to thank you for all the things you've done for me.
I don't care how many times I have to save you. No matter where you are, I will come to save you. That's how much you mean to me.
Hey, Claire, I didn't know you're already here.
Hi. How's Mother doing?
Oh, she's already asleep.
That's good. Thank you.
There was hostage taking that took place at the Gift for a Cause Bazaar early this morning. The authorities have already secured the hostages and the civilians that suffered from the incident. Meanwhile, Santiago Guerrero, who has recently disappeared while being tried in court, was seen in the area at the same time the crisis was happening. He was immediately apprehended and is now under the custody of the authorities.
So Rian survived the surgery. That's good to know. I knew she'd survive. Corazon won't let anything happen to her.
But as long as Chaga's free, my mission won't be over. My family isn't safe with him on the loose. You know what? I can't afford to not do anything.
Okay, listen to me. For now, let them close your investigation for the court-martial proceedings. And if you really want to be able to move without one of your hands tied behind your back to help in convicting him, then what you must do is find other ways. I know you're good at that. It's actually what you're best at.
How did he get arrested? I thought the plan Tiago was bragging about was foolproof. But we lost him and even our contraband!
My company is associated with that bazaar. If the authorities find out, I'm gonna get in so much trouble. Nobody's gonna get in trouble. Trust me, as long as our alliance is solid, we will be able to get through this mess.
What plan have you come up with, Franco? Don't forget, we need to get Chago out of jail.
A lot of eyes are on him right now. For now, what we need to do is to make the alliance even stronger. We can't let it end now. And what made you think we'd still choose to stay after what happened? Little boy, for your information, we can survive without you. But what if I tell you now that I can double the income that we lost today?
What do you mean exactly?
The general has been in this line of work for a long time, and through the years we've made a lot of contacts. I'll find someone who can help us. I'll personally clean up this mess, and I'll make sure your profit doubles, and everybody will benefit from it.
What's your plan, Franco?
First, there's something I want clarified. I need your respect and support now more than ever. Because I'm now the head of the Alliance, and now that the General's not here, you are all my responsibility. I won't let anyone leave, and I won't let anyone get left behind.
Don't you think you're being overconfident, Franco?
It's the General who taught me how to run things. We will rise again. We will set the general free.
We've had so much trouble today, and you're having the time of your life?
I was out doing my job. I tailed the soldier just like you told me to.
And what did you get from it? It didn't help any of us. Tiago was arrested by the military.
What exactly happened at the bazaar?
Isn't it obvious? Everything went down the drain!
The operation was too big and too risky. Too many innocent people got hurt.
People? What do you care about other people? Huh? What matters is that we're all safe. And you know what? Before you decide to grow a conscience, make sure you grow a brain in that head of yours! Never forget who they are. They're our enemy. In this world we live in, if you let your enemy affect your decisions, you lose! And you'll die too! Don't follow Rian's footsteps. Don't be deceived by the enemy.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congrats, sir. That was a big accomplishment.
Well, I admit it wasn't easy. We all know Chago was once a soldier, too. That's why we had foresight as to how he would act. They just needed me to take him down. And that's what we've achieved in doing.
It seems he'll continue to maintain a brilliant track record, General.
That's right, you said it. Let's keep it that way. So, how are things going here? Hey!
General Maximiliano, what will happen to Santiago Guerrero now that he's finally been arrested?
Will Mr. Guerrero's trial resume?
Where is he detained, and has he confessed guilt of the crimes he's being charged of?
You know, it's too early for you to be asking for official statements, but just to give you something to munch on, Santiago Guerrero is currently, he's under investigation. They're now looking into the validity of his claims in regards to the incident.
So, sir, what's going to happen to his trial?
There's nothing to worry about, okay? Chago Guerrero will undergo due process while he's in the custody of the police, and we will release an official statement once proceedings have started. But for now, let me assure the people that everything is fine, all right? Santiago Guerrero and Rian Bonifacio are now in custody.
And that's all thanks to you, General.
I only did my sworn duty, you know? Okay, so, we have to go now so we can do our work. Thank you, everyone.
Excuse me.
Rian is still unconscious, but at least she's safe now. There's nothing for you to worry about, okay?
Our daughter will be incarcerated. Even if I don't want her to be, she did commit actions that are against the law, and she must pay for them.
We'll do everything within our power so we can have a peaceful life, Marshal. And I promise you that I won't stop looking for ways to have your and Rian's name cleared.
Chago may already be in jail. It still doesn't mean I have peace.
But he doesn't have the power to do anything anymore, because he's already in jail, right?
You think his people won't move just because he's locked up in jail? They will stop at nothing to get Chago out, and to set him free. Until he's proven guilty of his crimes, he'll be able to find a way to walk free. And when that happens, I won't just sit here, looking at the screen, as I watch him burn down everything out there to the ground.
Get all the money and bring it here. Don't take long. We can't afford to keep Mr. Han waiting.
The military force deployed to the Gipsparacan Bazaar found Rian Bonifacio there. According to the statement of the military, Bonifacio obtained a gunshot wound while working for the military and Special Drug Enforcement Unit in catching the most wanted terrorist. Our trusted sources confirm that Bonifacio is now stable. And the authorities are just waiting for her to regain consciousness to get her statement about the said incident.
Bro, you think she'll be fine?
The news said she survived, right? Actually, if not for her, we wouldn't be drowning in this mess now.
You know what, Franco? That may be what you believe, but the look in your eyes say otherwise. Aren't you really worried about her? You know, even if the General says she's our enemy, honestly, I still can't find any reason to believe that she is. She risks her own life to save innocent lives while we kill people. Can you honestly tell me what we're doing is right?
Ivan, you must resist having those kinds of thoughts. I need you with me, especially with the General gone.
But Franco...
That's enough! If you're that worried about Rian, then go to the hospital. Keep an eye on her, and when she regains consciousness, find out what she tells the authorities about us.
Stay still. Your body's not strong enough. You're not allowed to move yet.
Rian, look at this. I made this for you while you were asleep.
Thank you, Eli.
Sir, you heard the answers that Chago gave? So, do you believe him?
What do you think, Del Fierro? We both know how outrageously cunning Chago is, but it doesn't mean we would deprive him of due process. We can't do that, right?
With all due respect, sir, we both know we also can't afford to just set aside our allegations against Chago. Sir, we can't trust that man.
Yes, I know, Major. I don't intend to trust him. That's why we can't be anything but thorough in investigating everything that he tells us. Don't let him have something to use to be acquitted.
Yes, sir. We're searching non-stop for the man who escaped from the bazaar, as well as the other accomplices of Guerrero.
I hope this ends soon. It's been too long. I want us to solve this case as soon as possible. Let's do whatever it takes, okay?
Yes, sir.
You understand?
Sir! This way, sir!
We almost lost you. Can you tell us who shot you?
It was Chago.
No, take it easy. The police arrested him. He's now locked up in jail. He's facing multiple charges. It will be impossible for him to pay his way to freedom.
Same thing, Ma. It's time for me to pay for the crimes that I committed.
Don't say that, sweetheart. I promise we will do everything to ensure that we clear your and your father's name. And then we can become a complete family.
According to Madrillejos, Banzon, and Abellion, you were involved in David Pascal's operations. He was an international terrorist. Isn't that the group you're talking about?
General, you don't need to answer that.
It's okay, attorney. It's okay. According to what they said, they only want to accomplish success in digging the whole truth. And I will do my part. I will cooperate. I will tell you nothing but the truth. I just have one request. That the authorities make an effort and do their best to look into my charges fairly. And not just believe things that conspiracy theorists announce on the radio. Let me ask you, have you actually been handed concrete evidence against me? Something that would prove my involvement in that syndicate? Or is it just all talk?
You and Pascal knew each other. These photos prove that you were together.
Marshall already showed me that picture. Major, do you remember General Marshall de Leon? This is someone who has always had strong motives against me. And I'm aware that he'll do anything to gather any possible dirt his hands could carry and smear my name with it. That's always been his goal.
Hey, it's your turn.
I'm Franco Segismundo. I have an appointment with Mr. Hyde.
I'm not going to wait. Don't take long.
Come in, sir.
Mr. Hyde?
Are you Franco?
Yes, I am. I'm here for the deal we agreed on. That you'll be the new supplier for the materials we need for our business. For the drugs.
Oh, sorry, but I don't make deals with losers. I heard about your operation at the bazaar, and you failed because you were negligent. That's why the authorities caught you like a rat.
How much is it?
50,000.
Look closely and see how old I am, Major. Can you imagine how many people I've met and crossed paths with? There's no way I'd remember each and every person who has taken pictures of me and I had pictures taken with.
We confirmed that Banzon knows how you operate. And when your trial was ongoing, a bomb went off at the courthouse, which resulted to the death of the witness against you. Explain
sir,
why
sir,
it's all
you
connected.
Can't answer. It's okay, attorney. No need to worry. I will answer this. I already told you. Rebels abducted me. I was kidnapped. And I was held hostage. There are people who want to milk my family of money.
And is that why your businesses involve drug operations?
Drug operations? Major, for your information, all my businesses are clean. I started from scratch.
And they were raided, and your businesses were shut down.
Listen, Major. That's just one of the ways for them to extort money from me. They want to earn money out of framing me. But I didn't give in. They were unsuccessful.
If I win this game, our deal is sealed, Mr. Han.
You're being overconfident. Fine, let's see how good you are.
All in. Straight flush. You're talking to a pro, not a loser. Okay, all my winnings go to Mr. Han.
What's this for?
It's down payment. There's nothing to worry about, Mr. Han, because we'll both benefit from this. And what we only want from you is to send us what we need for our business as soon as you can.
Please understand. I've done nothing wrong. I'm the victim in this mess.
I wonder what it will take for you to drop the act. You know what, Mr. Guerrero? My father was assigned to investigate a case. It was about terrorist children training under your leadership. And when my father was about to discover the truth, he suddenly died. Now I want you to tell me what your involvement was in my father's death!
Del Fiero. As soon as I saw that name tag, I knew I've encountered that name before. So Edgar Del Fiero was your father. If I remember correctly, he committed suicide. I don't get why you're pinning his death on me all of a sudden. Major, they say that sometimes there is more than meets the eye. The truth is, I've heard rumors that your father was a corrupt man. And here you are telling me he wasn't? You guys are unbelievable. So you managed to find another dirt that you want to smear my name with? Something that I don't understand and have nothing to do with? Tell me, are you guys planning to do the same thing that they successfully did to your father ages ago? My, my. Your father must be so proud.
Listen, my father did not kill himself!
Major! Let me go!
Major. That's enough! That's enough!
Sir, I was just interrogating him.
I know, but personal issues are not allowed here. Control yourself. Keep it together. Dismissed.
What's going on?
This is a warning, okay? Del Piero, if you do that again, I can't promise you you won't face consequences. You have to be calm! You can't let your personal issues affect this mission!
Yes, sir.
We can't afford to ruin our reputation, like what happened with General De Leon. Lieutenant De Leon, what have you gotten so far in the Bazaar crisis?
No one among those we've captured has spilled anything yet, sir.
Well, you have to investigate further. You have to interrogate them, all right? Talk to all the attendees. Knock on doors if you must. Just interview all of them. Talk to the staff and the suppliers. Chago's people couldn't have accomplished anything if they hadn't gotten any help from inside, right? You have to do that. We must know who they got their help from.
Yes, sir.
He had me taken so he could draw my daughter out.
Ma'am, it would really help us a lot in our investigation if you could give us proof that would confirm and validate your statement.
My daughter is on this bed because he tried to kill her. What other proof do you need me to give you? I chased him when he was running away. And that's when he shot me.
Mr. Chago Guerrero is denying that statement. And we haven't found any gun. That's a match for the bullet that was lodged in your body. But if you have any witnesses who could help corroborate your statement, that will be a huge help.
What do you need?
We need that gun that was used to shoot her. If you know someone who could lead us to it, it would help your daughter. Or any other witnesses. But I assure you, ma'am, our investigation on the case against him is ongoing. We'll be taking our leave now, ma'am.
You heard what they said, Ma. Our only option is to find strong evidence against Chaco. Seeing anything out of the ordinary that time? Or maybe there's another victim who could lead us to something that would help in the case.
We're going to help too, okay? We'll do whatever we can to help.
Thank you, Miss Isabel. Chaco's facing a lot of charges. We need to do what we can to make sure he's found guilty of all of them. We need something solid to use as a weapon against him. Something concrete and cannot be bent that we can use to hit him with.
Excuse me, sir. I'll just put these pillows inside.
All right, go in.
Thanks.
Let him in.
Rian. Wake up.
Ivan. Ivan, what are you doing here?
I didn't come here to cause any trouble. Franco just wants to know your condition.
Are you still using Claire for the mission?
I'm not using Claire. She's a good friend.
If you really see her as your friend, have you told her your real job and what you do for a living? Why you befriended her?
You know you're putting her life in danger, Ivan.
No, Rian. Everything I do so I can protect her. I care about her a lot. Truth is, if I could, I would abandon my mission for her.
What are you trying to say?
I want to leave the group, Rian. I want to study and finish college. I want to have the kind of life that normal people have.
Then why don't you do it, Ivan?
Because Franco needs my help. I can't forget that I owe them a lot and I need to repay them.
If you really think you're indebted to them for taking you in, then repay them by convincing Franco to leave the group. You both live in peace elsewhere.
I don't know how to do that, Rian. And besides, Franco will choose to stay.
Do what you can to convince him. You'll live your whole life not having peace. If you keep running from the authorities.
I brought pillows for the patient, ma'am. Excuse me.
Ask me out, Ivan.
Is there some place you need to be? I can drive you there if you want.
No, I had no plans. And besides, I wouldn't ask you to drive me because I don't like bothering you.
You know, I never see you as someone who bothers me. I actually enjoy it whenever I'm with you. Because you make me think better. Without me doubting myself. You know, Claire, honestly, I don't understand why you trust me so much. You have no idea how much you've helped me. But I've never paid you back. For all your help and kindness.
Hey, don't say that. You've helped me a lot. You saved my life plenty of times. And I must admit, I feel safe whenever I'm with you. Because I know you'll protect me no matter what.
Listen, Claire, you know, I don't think you should trust me at all. You don't even know who I really am. What if one day you find out that I'm not really who you think I am?
Is there something I should know, Ivan? Come on, will you stop doubting yourself for once? Even if you don't say anything, I know in my heart that you're a good person. Because you're my friend.
I'm so sorry, Pa. I can't visit you there.
It's okay, don't worry about it. As soon as everything is settled and our names have been cleared again, I'll make it up to you, sweetheart.
You don't have to, Pa. Just to know that you're all safe is already enough for me. And I'll be here to help you communicate with each other. Jesse will help too. We may not be together, but we're still a family. Ma, I need to go out to get a cup of coffee.
Okay.
Marshall, we'll call you again later, okay? So your daughter can get some rest.
Okay, bye. Jesse.
It's Ethan.
Aunt.
I'll leave you two to talk.
Thank you.
You know what, Claire? You're the first person in the world to tell me and make me feel that I matter and that I'm worth it. That I'm not worthless. Claire, you gave my life direction. I'm grateful to you for all that you've done for me.
Listen, there's really no need to thank me.
You know what else I'm thankful for, Claire?
What?
That you came into my life.
I beat ya.
How are you?
Still breathing. Thank you for helping me, Ethan. Thank you that you chose to help me.
I was only doing my duty. Listen, Rian. We're already talking to Chago. He's in prison and under investigation. Also, those we captured along with him. But none of them have said anything.
They won't cave in that easily. Chago has their loyalty. To the point that they'd choose death over betraying him.
But there's a lot you know too, Rian.
We came up against someone you work with. I remember him saving you once. Who is he? And who else were the people you worked with?
He's Franco Sigismundo. And we're childhood friends.